हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू योर इंग्लिश क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर लास्ट ऑफ योर सिलेबस, द लास्ट लेसन ऑफ योर सिलेबस, एंड दैट वी हैव टेकन वन ऑफ योर ग्रामर लेसन, एंड द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज प्रेपोजिशन. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर प्रेपोजिशंस. सो प्रेपोजिशन स्टूडेंट्स वी हैव डन इन आवर ग्रामर वीक ऑल्सो. सो same thing I am going to elaborate you now. So students, let us see what is a preposition. What is a preposition? A preposition is a word. A preposition is a word which connect the noun and pronoun to other words in the sentence. Okay, preposition is a word that shows the relation of a noun or pronoun to other words in the sentence. It shows the relation of a noun or pronoun to other words in the sentence. The other words can be nouns or pronouns or verbs. Okay, so the words that shows the relationship or they link the noun and pronoun to other words in the sentence. How do they link? That means they shows the relationship bit of noun and pronoun with the other words in the sentence. Let us understand them with the help of few examples. So I have written a few examples here. Let us see. The cat is sitting under the table. The cat is sitting under the table. Now here under is our preposition. Under is our preposition as it is showing the relation of the cat to the table. Here it is showing the relation of the cat to the table. Okay, here it is a noun. The cat is a noun and the table is also a noun. So here it is showing the relation of one noun to the another noun in the sentence. Let us take another one. The clock is on the wall. The clock is on the wall. Here on is our preposition. On is our preposition. So it shows the relation of clock to the wall. Clock is a noun and wall is also a noun. As I have said you from the definition, I have told you. So a word that shows the relationship of a noun or pronoun to other words in the sentence, and those other words can be verb, noun and pronouns. So here it is showing the relation of a noun to another noun in the sentence. So this word on is a preposition. So from the above discussion we can take conclusion. We can summarize the preposition like, a preposition is a word that shows the relation, that links basically the noun and pronoun to the another words in the sentence, and those another words can be noun, pronoun and verb. And how does it link? It links like it shows the relationship between them. Now we will understand the different types of prepositions. So students, now we will do the types of prepositions. So here we are, I have written three types of prepositions: preposition of place, preposition of time and preposition of direction. Though there are many more other than these types, but we are going to cover these three in your syllabus, that is preposition of place, preposition of time and preposition of direction. Now what does a preposition of a place tells us? What is a preposition of a place? Preposition of a place tells us the place of a noun in a sentence. They tell us a place of a noun in a sentence. And preposition of time tells us when does a noun do the action. It tells us the time of the action. Okay, and preposition of direction shows the movement of the noun in a sentence. It shows the movement of the noun, or it shows where the noun is directing towards in a sentence. So let us discuss them with the help of examples. Now students, let us know what is a preposition of a place. As I have told you, preposition is of place tells us about the place of a noun or a pronoun. So this is only the definition of a preposition of place. It shows the place of a noun or pronoun in a sentence. Preposition of place kya show karta hai? These are the words that shows the
प्लेस ऑफ नाउन एंड प्रोनाउन इन अ सेंटेंस. एक सेंटेंस में नाउन और प्रोनाउन का क्या प्लेस है, दैट इज शोन बाय प्रेपोजिशन ऑफ प्लेस. सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड देम विद द हेल्प ऑफ एग्जांपल्स. द कैट इज अंडर द टेबल. नाउ द कैट इज अवर नाउन. नाउ विच वर्ड इज शोइंग अस द पोजिशन और द प्लेस ऑफ अ कैट. इट इज द अंडर. सो अंडर इज अवर प्रेपोजिशन. The word under is showing us the place of the cat. So under is a preposition. The book is on chair. So the book is our noun. And which word is showing us the position or the place of a noun in that is the book? It is on. So it is preposition. Let us take another example. She is hiding behind a tree. So obviously the preposition will be behind as it is showing us the place where she is hiding. She is our pronoun, where our pronoun is placed. So preposition of place, what does a preposition of a place shows to us? It shows the place of a noun or a pronoun in a sentence. Now let us discuss the preposition of time. Now students, preposition of time. The preposition of a time, what does a preposition of time tell us? The preposition of time shows the time of action performed by noun or pronoun. It shows the time of the action performed by noun or pronoun. What happens here, students? Preposition of time actually allows us to discuss the specific time. It allows us to discuss the specific time when a noun or a pronoun does action in the sentence. And by that way, it makes the sentence complete. Okay, without putting the preposition of a time, we can't make a sentence complete. Okay, let us discuss them with the help of few examples. The first example is, I went to school on Monday. I went to school on Monday. Here, what is the action being done? Went. And when the action is being done? On. Which word is showing us when the action is being done? कौन सा वर्ड हमें दिखा रहा है कि एक्शन कब किया जा रहा है? इट इज ऑन. इट इज ऑन. सो इट इज टेलिंग अस व्हेन अ नाउन और अ प्रोनाउन इज परफॉर्मिंग द एक्शन. इट इज टेलिंग अस एक्चुअली व्हेन वी आर नॉट पुटिंग दिस प्रेपोजिशन. इफ वी डोंट पुट दिस प्रेपोजिशन, आई वेंट टू स्कूल मंडे, डज इट मेक अ कंप्लीट सेंस? नो, सर्टेनली नॉट. सो वी हैव टू पुट on here. So by this way it makes our sentence complete. Let us take another example. Rima was born in May. So here our action is born, and when the action is happening, it is though it is happening in May, but which word is telling us that it is happening in May? It is telling us in. It is told by in. So in is our preposition of time. Let us take another example. Mohan will arrive at 4 o'clock. When will Mohan arrive? He will arrive at 4 o'clock. The time is told by 4 o'clock. But which word is telling us, which word is connecting, which word is telling us that at 4 o'clock Mohan will come? It is telling us, it is being told by at. So, Mohan will arrive at 4 o'clock. So, at is our preposition of time. Okay, so this was your preposition of time. Now let us move to preposition of directions. Now students, let us come to our last type of preposition, and that is preposition of direction. So what does a preposition of a direction shows to us? It shows the movement of a noun or a pronoun in a sentence. It shows in which direction the noun or pronoun are going in a sentence. It shows the movement, it shows the direction in which they are going. Let us understand them with the help of examples. So the first example is, he is going to library. He is going to library. Now the word to is our preposition. To is showing us where he is going. Like he is telling us, it is stating the movement of the pronoun he. It is stating the movement of the pronoun he. The dog jumped in the air. The word in is our preposition. It is telling the movement done by the
dog. And the rat crawled into hole. The rat crawled into.
Now students, we have discussed all three types of preposition. Now students, now we will discuss what is the object of a preposition. What is a object of a preposition? So the noun which is followed by a preposition, which comes just after the preposition, is known as the object of the preposition. Okay, the word, the noun that comes just after, which is placed just after the preposition, it is known as the object of preposition. Okay, see, the clock is on the wall. The clock is on the wall. Here on is our preposition, and just after the our preposition we have a noun, wall. So wall is the object of this preposition on. Okay, the cat is under tree. Under is our preposition, and we have a noun, table, here. So table is the object of this preposition under. Okay, I hope you have understood it. Now students, just look on this page. Now we will understand some difference between the preposition in and into, on and upon. Let us read now. One should also note the difference between the use of in and into, and on and upon. Look at these sentences. The pencils are in the box. The rat crawled into the hole. Now what is the difference between in and into? The meaning of the both is same, that they are present inside or they are going. Okay, so the meaning is same, but what is the difference between in and into? When we speak of the things at rest, we use in. जब हम बात करते हैं जो चीज़ें rest पे होती हैं, when the things are stationary, we use in. And the preposition into is used when we are speaking about the things that are in motion. That means जो चीज़ें motion में होती हैं, जो movement में होती हैं चीज़ें, for those we use into. For example, the rat crawled into the hole. Now the here into is showing the movement of the rat. It is showing the movement of the rat. Though the meaning is same, but there is a difference. What is the difference? The difference is that in is used when we are talking about the things that are at rest. And what is into? Into is used when we are talking about the things which are in motion or which are in movement. Similarly, on is used while speaking of object at rest. For example, the basket is on table. However, we can use upon when we speak of the thing in motion. For example, the leopard sprang upon the calf. So what is the difference between on and upon? It is the same difference which was there in and into. On is used when we are talking about the things that are at rest or that are stationary. And upon is used when we are talking about the things that are in motion or which are in movement. So it is the same difference between on and upon. Okay, now let us look at the another list of preposition. The table below lists the most usual meaning of some of these preposition. Now above, what is the meaning of above? Above is higher than. For example, the plain blue above the clouds. And what is the over? So here in this table we are having the difference between above and over. Over means also above, but it is actually the vertical, when a things vertically cover something below, that is over. ओके जब एक चीज़ बिल्कुल दूसरी चीज़ को वर्टिकली कवर कर लेती है, दैट देन वी यूज ओवर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द शेल्व्स आर ओवर द सिंक. सिंक के ऊपर शेल्व्स है, तो इट इज़ कवरिंग द सिंक वर्टिकली, बिल्कुल उसके ऊपर कवर कर लेती है, दैट देन वी यूज ओवर. नाउ वी आर हैविंग डिफरेंट यूजेज ऑफ आफ्टर. आफ्टर वंस इज सी मी आफ्टर द डिनर, दैट इज लेटर इन टाइम. And next is after. R comes after Q. It is later in the series. किसी series में किसी चीज़ के बाद आना. And the rat ran after the mouse. किसी चीज़ के पीछे भागना. That is also known as after, in pursuit of, किसी चीज़ के पीछे भागना. Okay. These were the three uses of after.
देन द नेक्स्ट इज बिलो एंड अंडर. द सेम डिफरेंस विच वॉज देयर इन अबव एंड ओवर इज द सेम डिफरेंस बिटवीन बिलो एंड अंडर. बिलो होते हैं किसी चीज़ के नीचे. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी कुड फाइंड समथिंग बिलो द सर्फेस ऑफ वाटर. हम बिलो द वाटर सर्फेस के कुछ ढूंढ सकते हैं. नाउ अंडर इज अंडर मीन्स समथिंग दैट इज कवरिंग वर्टिकली. ठीक है, किसी चीज़ को वर्टिकली कवर करना. दैट इज द कैट इज हाइडिंग अंडर द बेड. बेड के बिल्कुल नीचे है. द बेड इज कवरिंग द बेड इज कवरिंग द रैट वर्टिकली. किसी चीज़ को पूरी तरह से कवर करना बिल्कुल वर्टिकली. ओके, इट इज द सेम डिफरेंस बिटवीन विच वॉज देयर इन अबव एंड ओवर एंड द सेम डिफरेंस इन बिलो एंड अंडर. सो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वर द वेरियस फ्यू थिंग्स. दिस वर द फ्यू थिंग्स दैट वर देयर इन द बुक. एंड दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट योर lesson that is known as preposition, in which we have learned preposition is a word that shows the relation of a noun or a pronoun to another words in the sentence, that could be verb and noun or pronoun. I hope you have understood it.